Okay, students, in this session, we are going for the one more type of accelerometer, and the name of the accelerometer is LVDT type accelerometer. Okay, we have finished in the previous session regarding the potentiometric type accelerometer and a piezoelectric type accelerometer. Okay. Now, in this session, I am going for the next accelerometer, and that accelerometer is LVDT type accelerometer, my dear students. Here, this is a LVDT type accelerometer, okay? Listen here. Here, there is no seismic mass, okay? Is there any mass here? There is no mass here. The core itself is acting as a mass, my dear students, okay? Here the core is attached to the two spring steels connected, one on the top and other at the bottom. Okay, now see here, this is a core that is attached to the spring steel. Okay, this is attached to the spring steel via this one is called rods. Okay, so with the help of the rods. Okay, now with the help of this arrangement, see, null position is there. Okay, now position of the core of LVDT is maintained. Okay, with the help of this particular arrangement only, spring steels and the rod, the core is about to set at the null position. The core itself is at the null position. Now here, how this operation is going to be taking place, let me explain. Okay, here, when the instrument is subjected to the vibrations, when this particular instrument is subjected to the, see what I am going to do, when I am, this is vibrating, when I am vibrating, here this is instrument is vibrating, then the core moves up and down. This core is moving up and down, then the voltage is induced into the secondaries. Thus at the output terminals you are going to get the output, that is the output voltage. Okay, so whatever the voltage you are going to get over here, the voltage having amplitude, this voltage is having what? It is having the amplitude which is directly proportional to the magnitude of the above vibrations. Okay, once again I'm repeating, see whatever the voltage is, okay, when the core is moving up and down, then the voltage is induced into the secondaries. Okay, whatever the output you are getting, this voltage, okay, that is okay, is directly proportional to the, okay, the voltage is having amplitude, okay, and that is directly proportional to the magnitude of the vibrations. Okay, now when compared to the potentiometric accelerometer, here this natural frequency is also less, around it is okay, how much it is in potentiometric, it is 30, but in here it is 80 hertz. Okay, so this method is also used in the low frequency vibration measurements or steady state acceleration. Here what happens, compared to the potentiometric, this particular method is resolution is somewhat better, and it is intermediate between potentiometric and piezoelectric. Okay, so here it is the advantages of their intermediate between potentiometric and that is piezoelectric. Okay, first one potentiometric, followed by LVDT, followed by last one is piezoelectric. Okay, this is about the LVDT type accelerometer. Okay, so in this session I am going to once again depict you, okay, that is the differences. This is a potentiometric accelerometer here. Okay, what happens to the natural frequency? The natural frequency is around how much it is, my dear students? It is around 30 hertz. Okay, now here what is the disadvantage? In these accelerometers, sliding contacts are there. Okay, and in LVDT type accelerometer, there is no sliding contacts. Okay, this method is somewhat better than the previous method. Okay, now when it comes to the piezoelectric, I am going to use here the piezoelectric crystal. Here I am going to use the piezoelectric crystal. Now here what happens, according to the features, if you are going to see the features, it is limited in use. Its natural frequency is very high. How much it is? Around 100 kilohertz. So it is used in very high frequency measurements or steady state acceleration. Okay, here the advantage is that the crystal itself is acting as a damper and a spring, my dear students. Okay, that is the advantage of going this particular method. Okay, so out of these particular three methods, we are going to prefer piezoelectric accelerometer, my dear students. Thank you very much for this session. In the next session, So we have finished about the measurement of acceleration and we have finished about the measurement of vibrations. We are going to see the model problems based upon the till now completed concept formula. Thank you.